And we welcome you to Chapel Hill, North Carolina, with the Tar Heels taking the field here at Keenan.
Is Maurice French will accept that opening kickoff, and we are underway. French a yard deep, and he's coming out. Angles at the 10. Gains the 20, and up near the 25 on the return for Maurice French. 25 yards on that return. Time for the Food Line Impact players. We go to Jimmy Morrissey, the center for the Panthers.
Yeah, sophomore center. He calls the shots up there. Started 15 consecutive games up front. He'll help out with Kenny Pickett and start calling out some of these blocking schemes that Pitt's going to have to use in that run game and the pass game. The former Waka, and I can assure you he is on scholarship now at Pitt.
Kenny Pickett, the sophomore from Oakhurst, New Jersey, at the controls. Olsen to his left, now to his right as he directs some traffic. Pickett, quick toss. It'll be a minimal gain, maybe 3 yards to Rafael Arujo Lopes as we go back to our Food Lion Impact players.
Now, we saw Cole Holcomb in that opening piece right there. Holcomb is an outstanding player, led the team in tackles a year ago. He's already leading the team in tackles through two games this season. He's going to kind of have to come up big. Also call some of the shots defensively to make sure they get some of this motion and window dressing that Pitt likes to throw at you. Get it sorted out.
Second down for the Panthers. 2-1 on the season. 1-0 in conference play with their win last Saturday at home against Georgia Tech, 24-19. Pickett has his man and a first down. George Aston falls forward past the 35-yard line. They got 8. The sticks are going to move for the Panthers.
Good quick throw here by Pickett. Aston flanks the defense. Pickett gets the ball on him right now before North Carolina can react. And a good second down play after not getting much out of first down. They get a second down, first down.
Sixth catch of the season for George Aston, the senior from Stevens City, Virginia. And a first and 10 at the 36-yard line. Kenny Pickett against Georgia Tech. Those 179 yards, a season high in the early going this year in 2018. First down run for the Panthers, maybe one for Quadri Olsen, the senior from Niagara Falls, New York.
Well, Tom, you can bet it was pounded in North Carolina's head that Olsen and Hall and Davis, all these backs, big backs, are going to be coming downhill. North Carolina shuts the door right here. Excellent job of playing team defense, gap conscious, takes away the Olsen run.
It was a loss at home earlier in the season against Penn State for Pittsburgh, but Olsen performed well in that game. 119 yards rushing in the losing effort for the Panthers. Pickett's pass is caught up past the 40-yard line by Olsen. He's ridden out of bounds after an 8-yard gain. The clock will stop. KJ Sales on the stop for North Carolina.
Yeah, good quick read by Pickett. Got pressure off his left side. Immediately got the ball in the flat to Olsen. And he had already outflanked Holcomb. He's got really busy today. Going to have to take care of the run game. He also going to have to cover some of these backs out of the backfield.
Third and short for the Panthers. At 43%, eighth in the conference, trying to convert early on here in the first quarter against the Tar Heels for the 45. Pickett going to forge ahead, and it appears that he has enough beyond that 41-yard line, 2 yards on the run, and it is a first down for the Panthers.
Hey, look at this Carolina defense. They've been put in kind of a victim of circumstance a little bit. They've been on the field a lot more than I think they would want them to be on the field. The North Carolina offense has not been able to convert on third down. Subsequently, this North Carolina defense has had to play a lot of minutes. Got some people they're playing without through some injury and other circumstance. So trying to rally and hold on to the rope defensively.
Losses at Cal and at East Carolina for North Carolina. On the rollout, the pass complete near midfield. It's going to be George Aston again who put the shoulder down. Miles Wolfo made the stop. 7 yards on the play. Time for our Carolina Ford dealers. Keys to the game with Dave Archer.
Now, North Carolina got to find a way to finish. They have only scored 3 points in the second half, so they want to play as low in the second as they have in the first half, and they've lost to North Carolina in the fourth quarter last 2 times they faced them. And for North Carolina on offense, they're going to need to have some success on first down to get themselves in some manageable third down situation. They're converting at only 27% on third down on offense.
Second and 2 for the Panthers. North Carolina has won 5 in a row in this series, all with both teams as members of the ACC, and Pickett is going down back at his own 40-yard line. Tamon Fox is number 12 on the play for the Tar Heels.
Now, Tamon Fox is going to get credit for the sack, but a little bit of a jam right there up the field. Knocked the receiver down. Might have could have got an illegal chuck downfield right there, but no call. And Tamon Fox is the benefactor. Good pass rush off the edge. They need some pass rush. Tom playing without Malik Kearney today. Their outstanding edge rusher. Going to need something from Fox and Cater today.
A loss of 14 on the first sack of the season for Tamon Fox, who had four sacks in 2017. Third and 16. Pickett's pass. Hauled in at the 35, but it's going nowhere. Darren Hall made the catch, but he has stopped. Cole Holcomb makes the tackle, a loss of four.
We're talking about Cole Holcomb. Here he is right here, going to read the screen and jump it right away. Immediately sees it, beats the lineman to the block, and puts Hall on the ground. We talked about Holcomb. He was going to be busy today. Makes a big play on the opening series.
Daz Newsome is the deep man, standing at his own 25-yard line, ready to accept this punt from Kirk Christodoulou. Newsome will watch it sail out of bounds. The North Carolina defense comes up big. Holcomb with the stop. No score in the first. Stadium, home of the Tar Heels since 1927. They'll go razzle dazzle. Elliott has to find a man in the flat. It's complete. Ratliff Williams up the sideline. He's got first down yardage. Head up to the 43-yard line. 13 yards. First play from scrimmage for the Heels.
Tom, excellent decision by Elliott. He gets pressure through the middle and he finds his check down, which happens to be his best receiver, and Ratliff Williams out to his left side.
Yeah, they faked that run play to Antonio Williams.
Wanted to take a deep shot, but pressure didn't allow it, and a good decision by the quarterback to get the ball out.
Tar Heels 0-2 on the season. Their game was postponed last week against Central Florida. Would have been the home opener. This one to Antonio Williams. It's a short gain for the Tar Heels.
Let's take a look at this opening play. Going to try a little gadget that North Carolina's known for, looking for the deep shot, but didn't get the protection. Excellent job of Elliott to feel the pressure and get the ball out for a positive pickup.
Second and 9 now for North Carolina. Last game they played was September 8th at East Carolina, a loss 41-19. This to Michael Carter. He's looking for midfield. He's got that. He's up near the marker as well. 10 yards on the play. Michael Carter.
Well, he's our food line impact player for today. Michael Carter back from injury, averaged 5.8 yards a carry, and they are really excited to have this kid back because he is the game breaker. Home run hitter at 8 touchdowns in 2017.
Elliott lofts it down the field, and it falls incomplete. Too far for the group back there.
Now this is excellent coverage by Pitt, trying to pull the safety down, using a little play action fake, get the safety to squat down. He does not. Stays in the middle field, and then Dane Jackson is in perfect position as the corner. Ball might have been outside a little bit too far for Roscoe Johnson to react to, but really good coverage by Pitt in the back end.
Brings up second and 10 for North Carolina. To the ground, right side, Jordan Brown. Junior from Durham, North Carolina, has 6, and back to the food line impact players.
Well, talked about the middle backer for North Carolina. Quentin Worginis is also one of those guys that makes a lot of plays in the middle. He's got, this is his 42nd consecutive game, or 42nd game as a Pitt Panther. Missed all of last year with an injury. He's excited to be back on the field for Pitt.
Third and 4 from the Pittsburgh 40-yard line. Williams is the running back to the left of Nathan Elliott, the junior from Salina, Texas. Pass is caught. Williams trying to get to that first down marker.
Excellent tackle by Worginis to keep Williams short of the first down. Yeah, he's going to be marked short, Tom. This is excellent hustle from the middle back of Worginis. Going to run to the outside, gets outflanked initially, but does a good job of wrestling Williams to the ground short of the first down.
Leading tackler on the team, Quentin Worginis, making the play. North Carolina is going to go on fourth and one. 4 for 6 in this situation this season for the Tar Heels. Short yardage up the middle. Williams through the line. Williams trying to run it to the end zone. And he is in. Tar Heel touchdown.
Watch the left guard, going to pull around and get in front of Williams. Gets a key block right there. Watch the little sidestep now. Makes Briggs miss right there. And then Williams is off to the races. 96 yards 2 weeks ago against ECU on just 6 carries, but was ejected from the game for a targeting foul on a block. They missed his services in the second half, did North Carolina, in that loss. But you see his ability to make some plays. The transfer from Ohio State.
His second TD run of the season, had one against Cal as well. Antonio kind of scoring a touchdown for the first time this year on the opening drive. And right now we're going back to the studio in Charlotte. Boston College and Purdue. Katie has the update.
Thanks, Tom. Let's head up to Ross-Ade Stadium in West Lafayette, where Boston College just tied it up.
Boston College quarterback Anthony Brown facing a 3rd and 14. Hits tight end Tommy Sweeney for a 15-yard touchdown pass.
2 minutes to go in the first. It is a tie ball game, 7-7. Tom, Dave.
Boy, how about Anthony Brown coming off a monster week a week ago in the win over Wake Forest and off to a good start today.
North Carolina takes 2 minutes and 49 seconds to go 70 yards and take the 7-0 lead. Olesen, second level, up there midfield and finally cut down on the North Carolina side of the 50.
Well, this is excellent vision by Olesen. It's just a stretch play and he looks for a crease and then puts his foot in the ground and finds that crease on the cutback. And a touchdown saving tackle in the back end for North Carolina. But you're talking about 6'1", 225 pounds coming downhill at you. That's a tough guy to handle right there.
It's 28 yards for Quadri Olesen. Leading rusher on this team, averaging over 6 yards per carry. That average going up after the last play. This one incomplete on the pass attempt is Shockey Jacques-Louis.
Well played by North Carolina that time, trying to throw a quick screen to the outside. North Carolina right in position to make the play. Dominic Ross, the linebacker.
Here's our 1st and 10 line, Dave, brought to you by LendingTree, official loan shopping partner of the ACC. Dave, that last pass, the first incompletion of the game for Kenny Pickett, who was 5 for 5 on the previous drive to open up the game for Pittsburgh. Pickett. And now back-to-back incompletions. That's too high for Taysier Mack, the sophomore.
Well, jam. Got a good jam on the outside to K.J. Sayles. And it might have been the wrong guy to throw to. I think Pickett had the slot throw, decided to try to rip it to the outside. But Sayles is in perfect position to take that one away and force 3rd down.
See the call from John Papuchis, 4th-year defensive coordinator for North Carolina. 2nd year. As the defensive coordinator and 4th year on the staff. 3rd and long for the Panthers. From the 47 of North Carolina, deep drop from Pickett, dancing around. Lunging forward to the 40, gonna be a little bit short of that 1st down line at the 37.
Well, Pickett does an outstanding job of keeping this play alive. North Carolina Tar Heels all around him, makes a couple people miss and actually pushes this up where you, if you're Pat Narduzzi, will consider going for it here now. Got inside the Carolina 40-yard line. Good job by Kenny Pickett to keep it alive.
Pittsburgh has not converted on a 4th down this season. They are 0 for 3. This is their 4th game of the year. Pickett wants to try to get it done around the left side. He's got a 1st down out of bounds near the 30-yard line for Kenny Pickett, the quarterback, and he got 9.
Yeah, just a diamond setup in the backfield. Really, all the backs are in the block. This is a call run for the quarterback all the way. They make it look like zone read, but that's just window dressing. All those backs are in to lead the play. He gets a nice convoy to get him to the edge, and Pickett runs for the 1st down.
First 4th down conversion of the season for Pat Narduzzi and the Panthers. Coach Narduzzi in his 4th year, 23 and 18 overall. Darren Hall with the run, and for more on Kenny Pickett, down to the sidelines, and LaRisha Harris.
So I spoke with Kenny Pickett earlier this week, and he told me having the ability to hurt the defense with his legs and moving the sticks on third and short and being able to run to help move the chains to keep the drive alive is a few of his strengths. He also said his second biggest strength is accuracy, and an impact he wants to leave is being efficient in managing the game and being a guy who's mentally sharp, and obviously he's doing that right now.
He had a big day in his first start against number two Miami a year ago running the football.
24-14 win for the Panthers against the Canes at the end of the season last year.
Yeah, both these teams, Tom, would like to have, you know, any team would like to have success on first down, but both of them are not necessarily built for second and long, third and long. So when you miss a play like that, now you're forced into third and long when you try to pick up incremental pieces to keep yourself in manageable third downs. Now North Carolina and John Papusius can come with some of his pressure packages right here and disregard the run game.
Now Pickett connected on his first five passing attempts, Dave, but has missed on his last three. Third and seven, 4:25 on the clock in the first quarter. Pickett over the middle. That is complete, Maurice French. And this one's going to be awfully close near that 20-yard line of North Carolina, and the completion to French.
This short, Tom, looks like based on what we can see from here. So North Carolina, so Pitt will go again here on fourth down. Good job by French to get to the inside. That was the key on the play. It was an RPO, a run pass option. Fake the handoff and get the ball to French. But French is the key for his route is to get inside Morrison on that slant. So there's a throwing angle for Pickett.
Another fourth down situation. Ninth play of the drive upcoming. It's going to be real close. It's Kenny Pickett again on the keep. Trying to sneak it across the line near that 20.
But there's a tremendous amount of belief in this offensive line that can come off and get some movement to move the ball a yard. This one is less than a yard.
And it was enough for the second conversion on fourth and short for the Panthers.
Boy, just barely though, Tom. They had to break the 20 and just barely broke the 20.
So the Panthers right on the edge of that red zone. First and 10. Handoff. Olesen inside the 10. And it takes several Carolina blue-shirted defenders to bring him down. 13 yards through the middle, Quadri Olesen.
Well, North Carolina gets some penetration, but Olesen at 225 runs through the arm tackle. This is what we talked about in the opening, about his big body and being able to rip through tackles. If you don't hit him straight down the middle, you're going to have a tough time controlling Olesen, and he showed it right there again. Power running right through the middle.
First and goal for Pittsburgh. Keep in mind they have converted two fourth and shorts on this drive. Pickett turns at the five, dives for the pylon. Touchdown, Pickett. What an effort. 7 yards on the run. Kenny Pickett has the TD for Pittsburgh.
Yeah, very similar play. In fact, the same play they ran to get the first down on their second fourth down conversion of the day. Pickett's going to get a convoy, and it's Aston. The fullback gets the key block on the outside. It gets Gimmel, the linebacker, and then Pickett dives to the pylon, and Pitt's on the board.
Second TD run of the season for Kenny Pickett, and what an effort by the sophomore to get to the corner. Kessman's extra point will tie it up. 7-all. So the Panthers respond. And after the Pickett TD, we'll be back after a word from your local ACC station. Will not come out of the end zone with that one. As Dave talked about, in last year's game, in the victory for North Carolina, Ratliff Williams returned the opening kickoff 98 yards for the score, but it's Pittsburgh getting on the board, Dave. 11 plays and 75 yards.
Yeah, outstanding job. Converted on fourth down a couple times in the drive, and were able to punch it in with Pickett running behind some blocks in front of his fullback and his two remaining backs. So excellent job of using that power running game to move the ball down the field.
First and 10 for the 25 for North Carolina. We are tied at 7 here for the first quarter. That's complete. Up the sideline, Daz Newsome. And a first down as we check in with Larisha.
Hey guys, so I just saw number 20, Jonathan Sutton, for the Carolina Tar Heels being carted off. He had taken off his cleat on his left foot. I'll have more for you coming up shortly.
Larisha, thank you. 18 yards on the play for Larry Fedora's Tar Heels. Seventh year in Chapel Hill for Coach Fedora. Turning is Newsome, trying to spin away from the defenders and finally wrestled down by DeMar Hamlin. He's got 5 yards on his second consecutive grab.
That's a good tackle in the open field by Hamlin. This is the guy, we talked to Larry Fedora. Who would you like to see the ball in open space in his hands? And it's Daz Newsome. Newsome just had to play prior for the big pickup. That time, a good tackle by Hamlin in open space right there. That guy can fly in Newsome.
Don't forget, next week we're going to Raleigh, just up the road, Virginia and NC State. The ACC Game of the Week on Raycom Sports. Second down. It's a dancing Michael Carter. Maybe back to the original line of scrimmage for Carter. No gain on the play.
Excellent penetration up front by Pitt. Kind of blew the play up. Carter had to dance around in his own backfield and was just trying to fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Excellent job of winning the line of scrimmage by Pat Narduzzi's defensive front.
Coach Fedora, 26 and 14 here at Keenan Stadium. Also 5-1 in home openers. That loss came last year in the first game of the year against Cal. Elliott, left side, down the sideline, pulled in. Anthony Ratliff Williams near the 15, went up and took it away. He's got the catch as he battled with Dane Jackson, 37 yards on the play.
Yeah, big time play by Ratliff Williams on the outside. This is the number one receiver. It's a 50-50 ball, and Ratliff Williams comes up, goes up and takes it away from Dane Jackson. That's what you're looking for when you put your guy up to bat.
Elliott to the end zone. It's too far.
That's good coverage on the wheel route. Elijah Zeiss, the linebacker, does a good job of not being deep by the flat. Stayed right in the hip pocket. The tight end.
Jared Walston, Dave, was that intended target.
North Carolina a little banged up at linebacker, so they're having to reach into their depth a little bit to get some tight ends on the field.
Elliott hands it off. Jordan Brown. And inches his way towards the 5-yard line. They have him down at the 6. He got 9 yards on the handoff from Elliott. Dennis Briggs on the stop.
Yeah, Brown had five carries, 70 yards a year ago against Pitt. So another guy that's excited to see Pitt in the building. This North Carolina offense has really hadn't been able to hit its stride this year in the two games they played. And they had a really good game against Pitt in Pittsburgh a year ago.
Teams met November 9th of last year. A win for North Carolina at Pittsburgh, 34-31. And that ends the first quarter of play from Chapel Hill, North Carolina, with the heels knuckled towards the goal line as Williams just short of the goal line, but he does have a first down after 6 yards on the play. Here's our red zone brought to you by CPI Security, the official security partner of the ACC. This is the first time into the red zone in this game, because the TD run was 37 yards over the top and in. Antonio Williams, and he's got his second TD of the game from a yard out, elevating for the touchdown.
Yeah, Antonio Williams running with a lot of purpose. That third down run pushed it inside the 1 yard line, and there was no doubt on this one. Just powers it in the end zone. Looked like Sam the Bam Cunningham from way back in the day.
Third rushing touchdown of the season, second of the game, Antonio Williams. Extra point from Freeman Jones. 14-7, Tar Heels. And their per diem, and for more on that effort by the Tar Heels, it is Gatorade heard around the cooler with Larisha on the sidelines.
And as we just saw, you guys, that relief effort for the team here, the Tar Heels, all initiated from a former player himself, Kevin Reddick. He called the group up and the program responded. As you said, Tom, everybody donated their per diem to the game. 85 scholarship players, actually, and the football team, they also donated their equipment truck, loaded it up with supplies. They had so much, they even had enough for a second truck. And then those trucks are getting ready. They left out early Saturday morning to head to those in need.
Really tremendous effort by those here that were the Carolina Blue trying to help out.
This is Pickett on the rollout. Diving attempt. North Carolina says it's incomplete. The officials agree as Dontavius Butler Jenkins with a supreme effort on that pass play.
Yeah, bootleg play. Got him open. Looked like he got away with a little bit of a grab with Patrice Rene. Got a hold with a little grab there. Certainly didn't catch the football, so it hit the ground there. But a little grab at the top of the route.
Now, Larisha mentioned former North Carolina standout Kevin Reddick, who is from New Bern, particularly hard hit by Florence and hurricane damage. So a great effort by the Heels as we go to Katie and Charlotte.
Let's head back to West Lafayette, and Steve Addazio not happy about seeing this, Coach.
Purdue quarterback David Blough finds wide receiver Rondell Moore, 70-yard touchdown pass. It was reviewed, but stands.
Yeah, you saw his knee go down. Official ruling is a touchdown, so Purdue with the lead right now.
A little bit of a battle. Out of conference again.
Boston College trying to stay perfect, 3-0 at the moment. Best start since 2007 for the Eagles. This is 3rd and 5 for the Panthers. Pickett felt the pressure, got it away. It's too far. Aaron Matthews couldn't run it down for the Panthers.
Well, good pressure by Fox off the backside. This is the second time we've seen Tamon Fox around the quarterback. And you're right, Tom. He sped up the process for the quarterback just enough where Pickett couldn't pull this ball down in on his receiver, who had a step. Excellent job by Fox to heat the quarterback up, the sophomore from Lawrenceville, Georgia.
Chris Badulu in to punt for the Panthers. Daz Newsom will be the deep man. Newsom back at his 32-yard line. At the 30, he wants the fair catch and makes it six. Elliott's pass is complete. Adjusting to that ball, Deami Brown. And then he goes out of bounds. First down, 13 yards as Stocker forced him out.
Deami Brown, another one of these guys that enrolled early for Larry Fedora's team. How about that twisting catch by the freshman from West Mecklenburg in Charlotte, North Carolina? Enrolled in January early, went to spring practice, and he's a part of this wide receiver core, a young and kind of inexperienced wide receiver core. Ratliff Williams leading them, though, the senior.
Just the fourth catch on the season.
Sorry.
For Brown. First and 10. To the ground. Jordan Brown. Only a yard there for Jordan Brown, the junior from Durham, North Carolina.
Well, North Carolina's gotten some mileage out of their run game, Tom. They wanted to make sure they were able to run the football. It looks like Anthony Ratliff Williams is going to line up here in their wild Tar Heel formation.
A little bit of tempo now for the Tar Heels. So Ratliff Williams taking the direct snap. He hangs on to it, puts his shoulder down across the 50 and a couple of yards short of the first down at the 47. 6 yards for Ratliff Williams.
You know, you see this where teams use the old wildcat formation. Most teams have it, but rarely do you see a wide receiver as the featured guy that's actually going to run the show. And a good job by Ratliff Williams to run with some power through the middle to make this a 3rd and short situation.
So Elliott back in there, the junior quarterback. 2 for 3 on 3rd down in the game. They've got another one. And the ball came out at the end of the play. Ratliff Williams appeared to make the catch. The ball came out, and the indication is that the Panthers have it on the fumble.
The recovery by Cam Bright, the redshirt freshman. Let's see who gets the hit. It's an excellent throw. Ratliff Williams puts it away. And a big hit right there by Dane Jackson, the corner. Comes in and rakes the ball out. Number 11 with the left arm. knocks it out of there, and then Cam Bright, the freshman, dives on the loose ball. Big play by Pitt to get the ball out. Their seventh takeaway of the year.
North Carolina had its first down, but Ratliff Williams could not hang on. Jarring hit in the secondary by Dane Jackson to pry that ball loose, and it's back to the Panthers. First and 10. Salahuddin, stiff arm at the 40. Michael Salahuddin, the freshman, 23 yards.
Yeah, the freshman from Washington, D.C. We're told late in the day that he might get some snaps, and this is something that Pitt does a good job of when they run that jet sweep. A lot of motion, retrace motion. This time, Salahuddin is up the field for a first down. Talking to North Carolina's coaches about trying to defend that. They really had to be disciplined with their play calls and make sure they understand the change of strength and formation.
First carry of the season, Salahuddin. Down to the 40.
What a time.
National champs in 1976. Ran for over 2,000 yards as a senior. Over 1,000 every year in a Pittsburgh uniform for Tony Dorsett. That pass complete inside the 30. Maurice French pulls it in.
Good solid throw by Pickett on the move here. This is the wide side of the field. Sprinting, throwing the out to that side. Good job by French to secure the catch with Sales closing. Pitt really mixing it up right now. Sean Watson, offensive coordinator, had the jet sweep, got that in there. Then they faked the jet sweep and handed it through the middle and now get the quarterback on the move. So mixing up the play calling for Kenny Pickett.
From the 28 with the clock rolling, 9:45 and counting here in the second quarter. Handoff from Pickett is Olison. Tried to cut it back, didn't get much. One or two for Olison. Now time to test your knowledge with today's Aflac game trivia. Here's the question. Quadri Olison, one of six Pitt running backs to run for 1,000 yards. Who are the other five? And we already gave you Tony Dorsett and Olison. Can you come up with the rest? That is our Aflac trivia question. We'll have the answer in just a moment.
Maybe one that fools you a little bit in there, but they've had a long lineage of excellent runners at Pitt.
Olison, the 2015 ACC Offensive Rookie of the Year, as he went for 1,100 yards on the ground. That pass by Pickett is off target.
Yeah, pretty good tight coverage that time by North Carolina in the back end. Trey Morrison, the freshman, Greater Atlanta Christian in Norcross, Georgia. Good tight coverage. That's a tight window to throw the ball in. Pickett was not comfortable putting that ball in there, and just an excellent job by the freshman, Morrison.
Pickett,
it's Lewis was the one people might miss, unless you're a Pitt fan. I know you knew that one.
Panthers pass inside the 15, and French making the grab. What an effort by French to make the catch, and 14 yards.
Tom, what a throw and what a catch. You're exactly right. French working against tight coverage. Again, it's Morrison, the rookie. What a throw. He put it in that tight window, and French paid him off by making a tightly contested catch with Morrison draped all over him.
Three catches and 29 yards in the game for Maurice French, the junior from New Brunswick, New Jersey. French inside the five. They'll mark him out at the 2.
Tom, this is the fun part of this offense. Sean Watson going to call on a little bit. They're known for power running, but the deception they have built into it. This is just a version of the jet sweep. Now, this will go down as a pass. As he tosses it forward to French. French going to come from the wing, just toss it forward. It looks like he's still got the football, but here comes French out the backside. And a good hard run by French to push it inside the 5-yard line.
French, who only had 4 catches coming into the game, already has 4. To the ground and in the end zone. Quadri Olison from 2 yards out, and he walks it right in for the Panthers.
Stefano Millen, the big left tackle, going to pull out in front of Quadre Olison. And Pat Narduzzi's team pays it off. Number 70, Millen, going to come around, as is 76, Dentino. Dentino had the block earlier in the game for Olison. This time, two good blocks by that left side of the offensive line allows Olison to go in untouched.
So the Panthers, Dave, have turned that fumble recovery into points and have tied the game.
Boy, an excellent display of play calling by Pitt. And Olison, the battering ram, shoves it in the end zone for Pitt. Miss in the middle, and then he's off to the races to get it in the end zone. Then how about the power? The jump over the top, the athleticism to put it in the end zone. Definitely has the tools for success.
Three touchdown runs on the season right now for Antonio Williams, North Carolina, in its third game of the year after last week's home game against Central Florida was postponed. Antonio Williams, David, that's a robust average of 11 yards per game, according to my limited math knowledge.
Well, you combine his numbers. Remember, he was eliminated from the game for an illegal block in the ECU game. He carried the ball six times for 96 yards in that game. So 10 carries, 140, and two touchdowns. That's pretty good over his last couple of games.
Yeah, North Carolina had to start this season with two true road games for the first time since 01. Losses at Cal and at East Carolina, most recently on September 8th. Elliott off balance, just flings it towards his own bench area.
Yeah, good quick pressure by Weaver, the defensive end. Weaver going to come off the ball, does not bite on the fakes. He stays upfield all the way. No coming down the line with the play-action read, or play-action fake, and he gets a chance to knock Elliott to the ground. Elliott had to throw that football away to avoid the sack.
Sophomore Weaver on the edge, 6'5 and 260 pounds. 3.5 tackles for loss so far this year, and a roadblock presented by the Pittsburgh defense to Mr. Antonio Williams, and a loss of three. Weaver again on the play.
This is an excellent play, Tom. Watch him roll out of the block on the edge. He's blocked on the edge. He's going to spin out of the block and fold right in on make the play. Got some assist, but watch him on the edge. Plays off the double team. Does an outstanding job of holding the edge, securing it. That's what's called setting the edge in the run game defensively.
Getting help from Werginis and Idowu, former high school teammates who won a state championship in Pennsylvania at North Allegheny. Swing it off to the right of Newsom. Newsom breaks a tackle. First down up near the 40. They'll mark him at the 38 for Newsom at 16 yards. Weaver had to make that stop.
Now, Daz Newsom, this is the guy Larry Fedora said he wanted in his space with the football in his hand. Watch this, a little miss right there. Made Briggs miss the safety. And that play, because he missed that tackle, Newsom was able to get the first down.
Elliott with perfect placement of that pass. Now hands it off up the middle. Williams breaking away and into Pittsburgh territory. Across midfield at 14 yards. Antonio Williams on the rush for the Tar Heels.
This is a youngster that went to Ohio State, played in 2017, transferred in. He played at North Stanley High School in New London, North Carolina. In high school, had three consecutive 1,000-yard seasons as a high schooler. Boy, is he excited to be back home.
Played 12 games last year for Ohio State prior to the transfer.
With the Carter injury, Tom, who's now back in the game. But Carter was injured the first two games of the season. He's kind of their lightning bolt in the run game. Antonio Williams has really been that guy that's picked him up a little bit and helped him kind of maintain the run game with Carter out. And now they've got a two-headed monster with those two guys.
Carter led the team a season ago with 8 rushing touchdowns. Williams has 2 scores on the ground. They'll give it to Carter, wrapped up almost immediately. And a modest gain, 1 or 2. There is some activity post whistle, and a flag is out.
That's a good call defensively for Pitt. They bring Adowu on the blitz off the edge, and he runs right into the play. Number 23 plays off the block, and he makes the tackle.
It's our first penalty marker of the ball game.
After the play was over, personal foul, unnecessary roughness, defense, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Looked like Amir Watts, one of the rotational guys at defensive tackle, got a little extra here at the end of the play.
Riley Johnson is our referee this afternoon. So that's Watts. Spectator for the moment from the 31 of Pittsburgh for North Carolina, first and 10. Elliott with the time delivers over the middle, wide open. Michael Carter. Touchdown, North Carolina.
Talked about Michael Carter and his big playability. They love to have him back, but this is a blown coverage by Pitt. Both linebackers, Adowu and Merginis, take the play fake and run out of the middle of the field, and Carter runs right down through after taking the play fake for a touchdown.
Elliott with the TD pass, the second of the season. North Carolina has taken the lead, and we'll be back after this word from the Atlantic Coast.
To get caught looking this direction, and Carter's going to go right down between the two safeties here. Watch where Jennings get caught in looking to his right and the screen. After the play fake, Carter releases right down through the middle where Jennings is not in position to make a play or to bump him off. Pretty easy throw and catch for Elliott and Carter.
Second catch of the game for Carter. First TD grab of the season. As Dave mentioned, he did not participate in the first two games. Return from French. Flag is out. He's up near the 25. Get the word on the penalty marker with 5:50 to go in our second quarter from Riley Johnson.
During the return, holding by number 7 on the return team, 10-yard penalty from the end of the run. First down.
So Stocker got flagged for the infraction. Folks, to help people affected by Hurricane Florence, text Florence to 90999 to give $10 to the American Red Cross. Terms and conditions apply. And what an effort by all the folks in the Carolinas and really from around the country to help out the affected areas, particularly in North and South Carolina. Dave, I got lucky. I live in Fort Mill, South Carolina, which is just south of Charlotte, and we got some significant rains. But people out near the coast, up in the Raleigh area, really got some significant flooding. Even here on the North Carolina campus, some of the low-lying soccer fields were flooded as well. Thankfully, that has receded since. But what an effort by everybody to come together in the after effects of Florence.
Yeah, and the people are still struggling mightily there. There's still a ton of water running off and flooding in that area. And so just because the storm's been gone for about 5 days, doesn't mean those people aren't struggling. So help any way you can.
Athletic director Bubba Cunningham, kind enough to come by the booth before the game, and he showed me some pictures, Dave, of those soccer fields. Now, the top of the soccer goal is about 8 feet high. The water was about 6 feet high, but luckily, that was really the only significant flooding that they experienced here on the Carolina campus. This will be Salhuddin. And for an injury update to the sidelines and Larisha.
So we told you earlier about Jonathan Sutton being carted off the field. He had removed his left cleat. Well, he's now back out there. We saw him a part of special teams. He seems like he's good to go. He was warming up on the sidelines, and everything seems to be okay.
Well, that's good to hear. You know, you never like to see a guy carted off, so good that when they got him inside and got him checked out, he's in good shape and back out on the field. This is an area Pitt's been pretty good now. Third and short, fourth and short. They've been able to handle this. North Carolina is going to swell up against the run game, and Deshaun Watson have a little deception in mind.
The run past the 25. Olsen appears to have a first down, Dave, as he gained 2.
Yeah, Quadre Olsen is a guy that you can't really measure how much he's been worked to this team. Because of injury a year ago, had to shift the fullback. He'd been a featured back his whole career and had to play fullback a year ago, and had a big day against Miami in their win over the number 2 ranked team in the country a year ago, and now back at home playing where he likes to, and back into the eye or that tailback position. But they said that one of the great teammates that Pitt has.
He had 91 yards, a couple of rushing touchdowns, and the win against Georgia Tech at home last Saturday for the Panthers. Darren Hall, his teammate, gets his number 22 called in this instance.
It's kind of nice to be, you know, Allison jogs off the field. Here comes Darren Hall. All Hall did last year was run for 120 yards and four touchdowns in this game against North Carolina. Had a heck of a year last year. And he was the guy that Allison was blocking for as they moved Hall to the tail spot, and Allison played that fullback position.
Dave, how about the game we did at Duke for Pittsburgh? Darren Hall, two touchdown runs of 79 and 92 yards, the longest in school history for Hall in that win against the Blue Devils.
Very capable guy.
Aston forced out at the 35 and into that Carolina bench. Enemy territory for Aston as Morrison forced him out after a 6-yard gain.
Well, when we talk about injury, this is the guy that was hurt. Aston was hurt after the second game of the year last year. He is a multifaceted guy. You've seen him catch the ball about 4 or 5 times already today. Three catches for Aston already today. And he's the guy leading when you get those I formation type plays. He's the guy in front leading the blocking.
Had just 5 catches coming into the game, but as Dave mentioned, 3 for Aston through the air from Kenny Pickett, who has a 7-yard TD run that came in the first quarter. The other touchdown for the Panthers in this quarter, a 2-yard TD run from Olsen. This is Hall left side. Hall cuts it back at midfield. Darren Hall running for the end zone, and he will score for the Panthers. Dave, 65 yards, and we just mentioned the long TD runs he had against Duke a season ago.
Let's take a look at the edge. Good blocking on the edge, and then Hall is able to make a couple of North Carolina players miss once he got into the secondary and in the speed. But how about the cutback? Put his foot in the ground, the left foot in the ground, get to the backside, and then step on the accelerator. Darren Hall, how about that 1-2 punch? Allison coming downhill at you, and all of a sudden Hall steps on the accelerator and puts one in the end zone.
Hall has his second rushing touchdown of the season for the Panthers. Let's see what's coming up at halftime with Kate.
We'll send it back to you and to Dave, Tom.
Katie, thank you. What an exciting football game we've got here in Chapel Hill. Dave, we have our third tie of the first half, 21 all after the long run by Hall.
Both offenses are playing at a high level, Tom. The offensive lines are controlling the line of scrimmage. Both teams have got their run game going, so much like they've been in the past, tight ball game between Pitt and North Carolina.
How about 172 yards rushing for the Panthers in the first half? Ratliff Williams, 5 yards deep, will take a knee.
Let's take a look at this offensive line come off the ball. Get the pull out in front by Hargrove. He's the guy that gets the initial key block. Actually, really didn't need to block anybody. He got out in front and kind of was running interference, and Hall stepped in behind his big offensive guard and kind of got lost. The next thing you know, he really accelerates to the end zone. That's tough when you're North Carolina and you see Olsen go off the field and think, oh, we get a break from their battering ram, and here comes Hall in the game. So talked about North Carolina's backs. How about Pitt, what they can throw at you in the running back position?
481 combined yards between the teams here in the first half. Brown tries to spin away from a tackle. There will be no gain. Camp and Jackson combining all the stop for Pittsburgh.
Good play. Keyshawn Camp, number 10, going to flash right now in the backfield. He makes the initial hit. And then Dane Jackson, the corner, who was coming on a corner blitz off the edge, is able to finish it off. But Camp, the big fella on the inside.
Keyshawn Camp has a couple of sacks to his credit this season. This will be Brown. Once again, there is no daylight. Sean Adowu did.
Yeah, Adowu, the linebacker, outstanding linebacker, steps in and makes the play. 94 tackles a year ago for Sean Adowu.
Don't forget, next Saturday, Dave, coverage starts at noon with the ACC Blitz. It's Virginia at NC State. They have split in the last two meetings coming in 2011 and 2012. We're on our way to Raleigh, North Carolina for the Cavs and the Wolfpack. The ACC Game of the Week here on Raycom Sports. Inside of 2 minutes to go here in the first half. Elliott's pass to Brown. Makes his cut. up near the 25, but again, it's a short gain. Two for Brown. Zeiss making the tackle, fourth down for North Carolina.
Now trying to get a convoy outside to lead Brown up the field where Jennis kind of forces it wide, and then Zeiss, the linebacker, comes in and finishes him off. That's an excellent job by Pitt team defense to get to the football.
First three and out for North Carolina.
A couple times now.
He was great going for the deep ball and scored a lot of points on the quarterback challenge app. Download that today, presented by Coyote Tractor. Lent the punt. Arujo Lopes. Stutter step at the 40. Escapes a potential tackle and then gets leveled out of bounds. 41 yards on the punt, 10 yards on the return. Arujo Lopes, and the tackle made by Trey Shaw. All right, Dave, here's our track phone matchup to watch. The Clemson Tigers, number three in the nation, three-time defending champs of the ACC, taking on the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets in Atlanta.
Well, you see the numbers there. Number one in rushing is Georgia Tech. Number two in the ACC is Clemson against the run. So that's where the game obviously will be focused. Georgia Tech a little wounded along the offensive line, but it's an offense that you don't see very often. Clemson's done a nice job over the last couple seasons of neutralizing Georgia Tech up front. But it's being played in Atlanta, and Tech's had some weird days in Atlanta against Clemson.
They've had some success recently. They've won five of the last six in Atlanta against the Tigers. French puts on the brakes, restarts, and goes out of bounds near the 46-yard line. Best starting field position of the game for the Panthers. They got two on first down.
Had some success against North Carolina. Has Pitt with this jet sweep type action. French is going to get the football, but a good job by North Carolina to string it out. Look out, the Tar Heels string the play out. There's a lot of blue hats around the football, and they're able to push him out of bounds for a minimal gain. So a lot of running by French, but not a lot of success.
On second and eight for Pickett. Pass complete. Arujo Lopes. A couple of players go flying out of bounds. Cole Holcomb in on the stop. 5 yards on the play. The Panthers showing off their muscle against the North Carolina Tar Heels most recently. Darren Hall, 65 yards and a running TD against this North Carolina defense.
Opportunity to get off the field, and as you mentioned, Tom, this is Pitt's best starting position. They've kind of been playing from behind most of the game. This is an opportunity now with the game even and a short field opportunity. Have to convert here on third down.
Third and three for Pittsburgh. French, little shovel pass forward, goes out of bounds at the 45, and that should be good enough for the first down for Maurice French as DJ Ford forced him out, but not after 6 yards from French.
Again, very similar type play. In fact, it's the same play that French ran inside the five down to get him down close. It's just a little quick pitch to the inside, and then it looks like potentially Pickett's handing the ball off to the remaining back. So a little deception there. They have this power running game. You're trying to lock in on that, and the next thing you know, they're coming out the other side with a little trickery.
Brad Narduzzi so pleased with the team's effort against Georgia Tech. Took a 21-0 halftime lead and hung on for the victory 24-19 last week. Deep ball, Pickett inside the five. Flag is out. Taysir Mack was down there.
Well, Mack came up with the catch, Tom. This is an unbelievable catch. Ball was a little underthrown.
Defensive pass interference, number 35. That penalty's declined. Results of the play is a catch and a first down.
Takes a big hit, but you see Ross in position, but a good job of tracking the football by Mack. Ball slipped down between his legs. He was able to hold on with Ross raking at the football. That's just tremendous concentration by Taysir Mack. Well, whenever you eat a helmet like that, stand in and eat a shot as a quarterback, you love to have your guy make a play for you on the other end, and Mack did.
42 yards on the catch by Mack. Pickett stumbles down to the one. Tyler Powell, number 95, making the tackle, the senior for North Carolina.
Going to come with a little pressure off the edge this time to try to take away the run lanes for Pickett.
Dave, the Panthers have taken their final timeout of the first half. Time for me to tell you, exclusive tickets to the 2018 Dr. Pepper HCC Football Championship game on sale now. Purchase a four-pack and receive four $5 Bojangles gift cards and four ACC hats. Reserve your four-pack today. Also enter to win a luxury suite for 10 at theacc.com/suitelife. And 3 years ago, Dave, this North Carolina team was in that title game against Clemson, which went on to beat North Carolina, Virginia Tech, and then Miami in convincing fashion last year.
Well, that's what Larry Fedora's been preaching here at North Carolina. Yes, they lost their first two games at Cal, at East Carolina, but the conversation here has been, let's reboot the system. We haven't played a conference game yet. This is their first opportunity to be back in conference. Coastal foe in Pitt, who had a win over Georgia Tech a week ago. So North Carolina says, hey, we've got everything to play for, everything right in front of us.
Chance for the Panthers this afternoon to go to 2-0 in conference play. And both games in that Coastal division. Again, last year won by Miami, its first trip to the title game. 21-all. Panthers trying to take their first lead of the ball game. Just 40 seconds to go in our second quarter. Pickett. Forward. Aston. Touchdown, Panthers. And they keep up the creativity, and Aston goes in from a yard out on the toss from Pickett.
Boy, really difficult to defend. Keep your eyes honest. You're going to fake the handoff in the interior, and now Aston's out in front, just shoves it forward to the big fullback, and Aston goes in for the touchdown. Boy, he's paid big dividends. That's his fourth catch of the day. Talked about how he was injured a year ago. They talked about how important he was to the team, and they love having him back.
First TD catch of the season for George Aston, the senior, and the extra point from Kessman makes it 28-21. And the Panthers are out in front.
500 yards of offense between these two teams in the first half alone. Anyway, take a look at what Pitt's been able to do today. We talked about their power running game. That was going to be their featured part, their calling card, and Olison is a big part of that, coming downhill in the power running game, making you punish me up front. A little bit of zone read, and then of course Hall comes in off the bench and has the big explosive run for the touchdown. But they've mixed in some of this little gadgetry type stuff with the shovel passes. This time just kind of pushes it forward to Aston for the touchdown. But you're trying to swell up against the run and be physical. The next thing you know, here comes a jet sweep or something coming out the other way. So they've really kept North Carolina off balance on defense.
175 yards on the ground in the first half. They averaged 207 for eighth best in the conference on the ground for the Panthers. And Ratliff Williams will not return that one. Our coverage of ACC football being broadcast on AFN, the American Forces Network. We welcome the men and women of the U.S. Army, Air Force, Navy, Coast Guard, and Marines stationed around the world, and so proud to have you with us. Hope you're enjoying the broadcast.
It's a spectacular day here in Chapel Hill. Beautiful day.
Don't forget, coming up at halftime, Tommy and Katie from our Charlotte studios to get you updated on all the happenings in the ACC this afternoon. Plenty of highlights from Pittsburgh and North Carolina. The Panthers have just taken the lead. Little shovel pass forward to Aston. He's given the Panthers the 28-21 lead with 35 seconds to go, and the play does not have a chance to develop. Looks like delay a game against North Carolina.
Well, Larry Fedora upset at the...
for delay a game.
Well, Larry Fedora upset at the officials for... He ran down and was going to call timeout to avoid a penalty. And he got the clock reset, so no use of the timeout there for Larry Fedora.
So no penalty on the play. First and 10, 35 seconds to go from the 25. Elliott flips it out to Michael Carter, who got cut down almost immediately. Loss of five on the play. Dane Jackson coming up to make the play for the Panthers.
Well, this is a kind of a yellow light situation for North Carolina. You try to find a play, an easy throw where you might get an explosive, but Dane Jackson, the corner, who's made a number of plays today, does a good job of seeing screen, nice pass the blocker, and able to make the play on the explosive Carter, the running back.
Today we're approaching 550 yards of total offense between the teams in the first half. We told you at the top of the broadcast, all they do when they get together is play close games. 2 years ago when they played here, took a late North Carolina touchdown to win that game by a single point, and Carolina's won five in a row against the Panthers.
Yeah, Mitch Trubisky, who now slings it around from the Bears, found Bug Howard with 2 seconds left to win here 2 years ago. And then, of course, last year we talked about Ratliff Williams makes a catch with less than 6 minutes to go to beat Pitt at Pittsburgh. But for this situation, what Larry Fedora is reminding Nathan Elliott is, hey, let's take care of the ball. We're deep in our own territory. You've got something, go ahead and take it. If not, you know, let's just go in at halftime.
Elliott's pass nearly intercepted.
Yeah, and that's exactly what he's told him not to do. You can't take that shot. Adowu is coming off the edge untouched on the blitz. Elliott's got to take care of the ball. Ball shot through the middle, and Stocker, Jazzy Stocker, closing. Boy, he'd be the first guy to tell you he should have picked that off. What a great opportunity for Pitt to maybe steal some points here late in the half. I'd be surprised they didn't hand this ball off right here.
23 seconds to go. Williams is the running back. They go for Jackson. Down the sidelines and out of bounds, short of the 30-yard line. It was on third and 14.
And essentially, it was a handoff, just a quick screen, an easy throw to the outside. But what happened is he goes out of bounds. And so Pitt doesn't have to burn a timeout. They're going to get an opportunity to see a punt here and try to set up a return and potentially give Arujo Lopes an opportunity to return a kick.
Okay, keep in mind, since 2000, as North Carolina gets ready to punt, Pittsburgh has 22 kick return touchdowns, 12 on kick returns, and 10 on punt returns. So a late punt from Lent.
That's a low kick, too, Tom. He's got a chance.
Arujo Lopes, 26-yard line, beat the first man and pulled down at the 35-yard line. 44 on the punt, 7 yards on the return.
Time around the team right now, and boy, our prayers and everything go out to his family and everything to beat that thing. Alex, go get it. Knock it out.
Nothing risky from the Panthers in the last few seconds, and Larry Fedora's team will go to the locker room trailing 28-21 at halftime. Thanks to the touchdown grab from George Aston from a yard out. Darren Hall had a 65-yard TD run.
Defense can find a way to make an adjustment here and get a stop or two.
297 yards of offense for the Panthers, 244 for Carolina. And the opening kick of the second half is through the end zone. Here's our principal, financial, second half game plan.
Yeah, really simple for Pitt. You heard Pat Narducci talk about it as he left the field with Larisha. Finished the game. They only have 3 points scored in all the second half so far this year. And for North Carolina, 174 yards on the ground to Pitt in the first half. You have got to find a way to stop the run. Larisha talked to Larry Fedora, and Fedora said, hey, we're just getting our eye. We're getting lost a little bit. We're not fitting the gaps. I guarantee you they talked about that at halftime. We've got to fit against the run, get it stopped.
First and 10 for the Tar Heels to open up the third quarter and trailing 28-21 to Pittsburgh. It's Antonio Williams, who had a couple of TD runs of 37 and 1 yard in the first half for North Carolina. 8 yards on that carry.
I like that third down passing from Nathan Elliott, 6 for 6, average yards per completion. That's pretty good, right around the 8 number. Doing a good job of mixing it up. They did turn the ball over one time.
Williams trying to push that pile toward the yellow line. Maybe a yard and a little bit short.
They talk about those early drives, 2 touchdowns early, then he had the fumble, and they were in Pit territory when they turned the ball over. And Carter was on the long touchdown pass, but then 2 punts to end the half, which allowed Pitt to regain and take the lead.
Tar Heels seeking their first win of the season after losses at Cal and ECU to start the year. 3 for 7 on third down, Dave.
A little bit different formation right here for North Carolina. We see Pitt use this.
Elliott still has it. Elliott cut down at the 32-yard line by DeMar Hamlin on third and inches. They try to use the whole field and lose two.
Boy, that's a tough one. Running wide on third and short. You get the play fake. Thought maybe you could get the quarterback to the edge. And Weaver, Rashard Weaver, has been outstanding, not allowing anything to get outside of him. Forces Elliott deep. And then Hamlin, the safety, comes up and makes the play. So tried to trick him a little bit and get to the perimeter. And it's a three and out for North Carolina.
Hunter Lent, senior from Elon, North Carolina, to punt. Paris Ford on the return, 51 yards on the punt and just a yard on the return.
There is a flag on the play.
Good coverage, good kick, which set up the coverage by North Carolina, and then a good solid tackle on the back end of that. Trey Shaw, the corner, came in and made the tackle.
17 of the return team. Penalty is 10 yards from the end of the kick. First down.
Penalty is against North Carolina. Pat Narduzzi and the Panthers. He'll take every advantage he might be able to get there.
Oh, Pat is constantly working the officials. You see what they did the first half. Excellent. 5 of 9 on third down. Red zone opportunities. You want touchdowns when you get down there. That's exactly what they've done. And it's been behind that power running game. And they had to have gone in with some momentum the way they were handling the ball on offense. This is an excellent situation here for North Carolina, though. It looked like after a three and out, maybe Pitt would have some good field position because of the penalty. Now they're backed up.
Darren Hall had the long TD run there in the second quarter, as you saw the drive from the Panthers. A strong finish, 65 yards. Hall went all the way to the end zone in the second quarter for a long TD run for the junior from Youngstown, Ohio. This is the worst starting field position of the football game for Pittsburgh. There is some discussion before we can put it in play.
Yeah, trying to get the chain sorted out, Tom. You know, get that knot in the chain down there, and then it takes five to untangle the knot. They got it done, though.
Don't forget, Dave, next Saturday our coverage starts at noon. It's Virginia and NC State. ACC game of the week on Raycom Sports. We can't wait to get there. More business to finish here in Chapel Hill. Olison, nothing on the carry.
Virginia in conference at home against Louisville, as the youngster Cunningham starts a quarterback for Louisville, and of course the NC State on the road as they go to Marshall. So you see Olison limping to the sideline. That's not good. Padre Olison's been outstanding today.
2-yard TD run in the second quarter for Olison, although favoring the left leg as he hopped over towards that Pittsburgh bench area. 2nd and 9, opening moments of the second half. 13th all-time meeting, Pittsburgh and North Carolina. Tar Heels lead at 9-3 overall. Pickett tucks 15 and out of bounds at the 17 as he got rocked out of bounds by Cole Holcomb.
Well, it's a really good job by Kenny Pickett to string this out. North Carolina covers the two receivers that are out, but Pickett stays in a throwing motion or set up a long time and finally outflanks North Carolina's pursuit and then hits it up the field for a nice pickup to put him in a third and short situation. So excellent patience by Pickett. North Carolina has not been able to take the football away all year. Or they could use one here deep in Pitt territory.
5 of 9 on third down for the Panthers. This is Hall. He's going to have the first down near the 20. Needed to make the 18. Got 2 yards, and the chains are going to move as Holcomb again is in on the tackle for North Carolina.
Got in behind big Alex Buxer, 6'6", 315-pound tackle. Did Hall. Got just enough of a block so Hall could fall forward for the first down. That's a big first down, Tom. They're backed up and able to get out of the shadow of their own goalpost now and have an opportunity to put a drive together.
Pickett was 14 of 21, 123 yards and a touchdown in the first half. touchdown pass was just a yard to George Aston late in the second quarter. Pickett all by his lonesome. Just has to get rid of it. Dominique Ross with the pressure, and we're down to the sidelines and LaRisha Harris.
So, guys, I'm down here on the sideline, as you said, and an update on Quadri Olison. Right now, he's just getting that left ankle retaped. He seems to be okay. He just wanted to make sure that he felt sturdy and had a little stability, so he asked for his ankle to be retaped.
Yeah, just got it a little twisted up on it, his last carry. So that's good news. Good that Olison, obviously Pitt faithful, excited to get their big hammer back in the game, but nice to be able to bring in a guy like Hall who can really carry the mail as well. Excellent job by North Carolina in last play, Tom, on first down, defending the bootleg. No place to throw the ball for Pickett.
On second down, Salahuddin trying to get around that corner. Again, defense equal to the task.
Yeah, again, Carolina, when they went in at halftime, I'm sure they got chewed on a little bit, but Holcomb has got to find a way to take away some of this jet sweep. This is something they've had some success with. Handoff wide. You see 36. Holcomb, the leading tackler for the Tar Heels, in perfect position to make the play. And now third and long. So after an initial first down, North Carolina tightened their belt a little bit here on defense and has forced Pitt into an uncomfortable situation here on third and eight.
Pickett flush from that pocket, throws on the run, it's incomplete. Up near the 37-yard line, looking for Maurice French. It's fourth down for Pittsburgh.
And Carolina not sitting back. Holcomb comes through with pressure through the middle. It forces Pickett out wide, and then the freshman, Trey Morrison, is right on the coverage. So watch Holcomb, 36, drive the running back right back into Pickett, forces him off his spot, and he had to throw the ball away there.
Christo Dulu in the punt. Newsom waits at his 40. Comes up to meet it at the 45. Spin at the 49 and driven backwards. .33 on the punt. Lost one on the return. It was Miami, the team that they defeated, number two in the country in the last game of the regular season. Beat the Clemson Tigers. Not only did they beat Clemson last year, the ACC champs, Dave, 2 years ago, they also beat Penn State. So they beat the Big Ten champ and the ACC champ in 2016.
Yeah, outstanding job by Pat Narducci's team to step up in a big moment. Certainly last year was a big win for them.
Up the middle with Brown. Short of midfield, stumbles at the 48-yard line, got 5 yards.
You can see that quickness from Brown and Carter. A little bit different than Williams. Williams a little bit more a power guy, but Brown and Carter in the game, there's that little extra step of acceleration. Good changeup, having those backs rotate in.
3 of 8 on third down for the Tar Heels. Came into the game just 27% in third down situations, and now two penalty markers are on the field.
Pitt was going to come with a blitz with Adowu and Jackson, the corner. And Adowu got a little too early. Sweet went in and took advantage of it, the left tackle.
Number 8, jumping in the neutral zone, causing the offense to react. 5-yard penalty, still third down.
Well, Hendricks is going to get blamed for it, but it was Adowu, number 23, is there. It's going to come off. You'll see 23 flash on your screen right there, and Sweet sees it. He immediately comes off.
Antonio Williams on a much shorter third down situation. Thanks to the penalty, it is converted. Fresh set of downs for North Carolina after 2 yards from Williams.
A little Bronx cheer here from the Carolina faithful as they go straight ahead with the big back for the first down, as opposed to trying to get their quarterback on the edge as they did the last time. Well, look at this lineup for Carolina trying to spread Pitt out.
Pass is complete. Newsom. He's out of bounds, short of the line. For the first down, he got 9 yards, needed to get to the 35-yard line.
Now, what the quarterback's looking for in that situation and what they're looking for from the sideline is how many players are in the box. Can we run the ball? If it's a six-man box, they'll run it. if they spread out, then they'll throw the ball to the outside. There's not enough people to defend the perimeter.
First and 10 line brought to you by LendingTree, official loan shopping partner of the ACC. Elliott freelancing inside the 20, and Newsom pulls it in.
Well, that's a great call, Tom. That's exactly what he does here. Is he's going to step under the pass rush. Little play fake, steps under Weaver right there. And once he gets outside the pocket, he's able to find his dazzling playmaker, Newsom, on the outside.
15 yards and a first down, North Carolina, to the red zone. Elliott again to the air. This is caught down close to the goal line. Garrett Walston, and out at the two.
Well, North Carolina's run this play a couple times with Walston. The first time it was incomplete, but this time they're able to slip the tight end out against the linebacker Reginis, and they've pushed it inside the five.
15 and 19 yards on the last two pass plays. Going to try to run it in. Jordan Brown cuts the corner and takes it in. Brown able to stay upright and score for the Tar Heels, just an extra point away from tying it.
Well, they get in the end zone here, but I think they get away with a hold. This is the play before where Walston, the tight end, catches it, gets it inside the five. But watch on the corner here if Dane Jackson, number 11, gets held trying to get outside. Right there is a hold that the official did not call, and Brown stepped in for the touchdown. Jackson turned around and looked at the official like, what's going on here? No question, a clear holding call, but North Carolina is able to punch it in.
A one-yard TD run from Jordan Brown. We are all tied up. Carolina has tied it up, but the second half, Dave, has not been kind to the Panthers.
No, it is not. You look at the scoring there, it's almost inconceivable. 3 points is all they've scored in the second half in three games.
This is French, well, about the three, up the middle of the field and dropped near the 20. As we go to our Charlotte studios for an update, Katie and Coach.
Thanks, Tom. The studio update is presented by Hardee's. Try our char-broiled sliders and check out Bryce Perkins right here, Coach.
A little 36-yard scamper, but the key, he hurdles a Louisville defender for additional yardage.
After that, he finds Chris Sharp to end the drive with a 3-yard touchdown pass. Cavs up 13-3 in the third.
Virginia trying to take care of their house against Louisville. It'll be fun to watch Perkins next week as they take on NC State in Raleigh.
58th all-time meeting, and we'll have it for you on Raycom Sports next Saturday. Carter-Finley Stadium is the destination. Quadri Olison.
Boy, North Carolina doing a much better job of sorting out the run game. Strobridge going to be in on the play. Does an outstanding job for the D-tackle spot. Number 55 fights through the blocks and is able to get there. Comes down the line. Great pursuit. Got some help as well. You got Ross, Dominic Ross, the linebacker. But North Carolina done a better job fitting against the run. It's exactly what Larry Fedora said they needed to do. And so far, they've made it happen.
Last year's game was a 34-31 win for North Carolina on the road at Pittsburgh. Pickett throws it up near the 35, but it's incomplete. Rafael Araujo-Lopes could not haul it in.
Now, North Carolina making it tough on him. This isn't a bad throw by Pickett here. This is a play Araujo-Lopes has to make. Ball goes right through his arms. That was a play he needed his receiver to make. It has not been easy picking so far here in the two drives that Pitts had the football. But another third and long situation. Pitt just 4 of 18 in the second half of games on third down.
Pickett has to retreat and he slips down at the 8. Cole Holcomb bearing down on Pickett, who hits the turf. It's a loss of 13.
Are you talking about staying after the rush? Holcomb gets blocked initially by Quadri Olison right here in the middle. Gonna blitz through. Quadri Olison has him blocked initially, but then he throws him off because Pickett holds on to the football and he's able to get in and get on the sack. Excellent job of being relentless by Cole Holcomb.
Clock rolling inside of 6 minutes to go here in the third quarter as Crystal Dulo punts from his own end zone at the 38 on the return. I was in studio, Dave, and got to witness that great moment from 35 years Broadcasting ACC football here on Raycom Sports, and that's going to be a loss of 7.
Boy, great short field opportunity here, and a bad snap by Troll. Remember, this is the guy that's he's had a couple of bad snaps. He's been pretty solid today, but boy, came at a bad time, and now backed up behind the chains now is North Carolina with a golden opportunity to potentially take the lead here.
Started the drive with their best field position of the afternoon. Elliott races out of that pocket, still looking. Keyshawn Camp was trying to run him down. And now we got a Pittsburgh player who went down. That is Camp. He was the one in pursuit of Elliott.
The officiating crew's been. I want you to watch the edge right here. Here's Folston rushing right here. Watch him try to disengage. He's got hold of his jersey, and he cannot disengage. That's holding. The official almost pulls the flag and then decides not to. Not sure why, but that's holding at its finest right there.
North Carolina on third down, third and long. This is a floater caught by Ratliff Williams at the 30. Makes his move and gets the first down. Down inside the 25-yard line, Anthony Ratliff Williams at 21 yards.
Tom, we've seen Elliott with his improvisation, but this is outstanding. He gets outside the pocket and lets it go way before Ratliff Williams ever came out of his break. Puts it right on the money.
Beat Damari Mathis to get that first down. Coming around the corner is Antonio Williams with a head of steam. Collision near the 20 with Sean Idowu. Williams, yeah, slightly shaken up on the play, Dave. Yeah,
Carter bounced back in the game at running back. Looks like Williams is okay along the sideline. But he's run hard today, Tom. It's been a nice changeup for North Carolina with the backs the way they've alternated.
Three rushing touchdowns and a passing TD to Michael Carter for 31 yards to represent the scoring for the Tar Heels. Elliott stands strong to the end zone. It's caught and a touchdown. Deami Brown, 19 yards, and the Heels are back in the end zone.
Two freshmen going head to head here. Paris Ford is going to be the nickel corner. He gets beat right off the jump. And an excellent job of seeing it by Elliott to get his freshman the football right down the pipe. Deami Brown, that's another one of those guys that Larry Fedora was excited about. He talked about Newsom. But Deami Brown, the freshman from West Mecklenburg High School in Charlotte.
He's got the first TD catch of his career. And more importantly, North Carolina has taken the 35-28 lead here in the second half.
Little stop and go, Tom. He made it look like hitch. He got Ford. Watch him freeze. He stops and then takes off again. He lulls Ford to sleep. We're going to take a look at it right here. Once you see the top of the screen right up here, watch the corner's reaction when Ford shuts it down. He comes off, runs the hitch. Corner bites on it. He runs right past him. Good read by Elliott to see that and pump it down the middle to his freshman for the touchdown.
What a quarter for the Tar Heels. The 19-yard touchdown pass from Elliott is second of the game. And the one-yard run from Jordan Brown earlier in this quarter. And a 35-28 lead with 4:12 to go in the third.
And Tom, what started out as a series that looked like in doubt. Remember the bad snap. They had the short field opportunity inside Pitt's 40-yard line. Got the bad snap, backed them up. They find a way to get themselves in the end zone and take advantage of that small field.
245 passing yards for North Carolina, the most so far this season in their third game of the year for head coach Larry Fedora, and they've got the lead 35-28. Maurice French to accept this kickoff. By the way, French returned the opening kickoff of the season for Pittsburgh against Albany, 91 yards for a touchdown. Lost the football. Taken by North Carolina at the 28-yard line.
The kicker, Freeman Jones, recovered it, Tom.
It is Jones. He's got it back for the Tar Heels.
I didn't get the number on the Pitt player that had a chance to recover it, but he tried to scoop and score. Officials going to discuss this as a flag. There's a flag down on the field. is in that area of an illegal block. So
looked like Trey Shaw, Dave, made the initial contact to jar the football loose, and then Freeman Jones all smiles with the present right in the breadbasket.
Yeah, ball bounced up right.
Rolling on the field is a fumble recovered by North Carolina. After the play was over, unsportsmanlike conduct, North Carolina number 53.
53 is Malik Kearney, and he's not available today. So I'm not sure what number they saw, but he's not in uniform today. But an opportunity. Trey Tipton is the pit player that had the chance.
53's first unsportsmanlike conduct foul.
Well, that's kind of tough on Malik Kearney because he's not even playing today. So
that moves the football back to about the 43 of Pittsburgh. First and 10, North Carolina.
And the pit player that had a chance to scoop or at least fall on the ball was Trey Tipton, the wide receiver that was in on that kick return team and just didn't fall on the ball. Freeman Jones, John in the spot for North Carolina.
Brown dragged down at about the 35-yard line. 8 yards on the play. Rashad Weaver with the tackle of Jordan Brown, who has scored in this quarter on a 1-yard TD run.
And what a move by Brown in the backfield. Zeiss, the linebacker, was clean. He made him miss.
Second and short, North Carolina. Brown dropped.
Didn't make him miss that time.
Adowu, yeah. Loss of two.
We made Zeiss miss on the first down play, but Adowu is coming off that left side, that Panther left side from his linebacker spot. Blitzes right into the play, puts Brown on the ground, forces third down.
Adowu last season, all ACC selection, second team, making the stop of Jordan Brown.
A big play here for Pitt to try to get a stop here.
Five of 10 on third down in the game for North Carolina. Way above their percentage coming in, just 27% prior to the game on third down. They might get another one. This is Thomas Jackson. He's got it and more inside the 25. Dave, that's 14 yards. Hands on hips for the Pittsburgh head coach.
Great block by Walston, number 84. He lets the blitzer go, picks out the next guy to block, and it's where the middle linebacker, Virginis, the linebacker, gets blocked there by Walston. Excellent job by the tight end to sort it out and get the block, the key block.
Elliott has now used 8 different receivers. Second catch for Jackson, looking for the end zone, and it's too far for Anthony Ratliff-Williams. Dane Jackson, step for step.
Those two had a battle on a 50-50 ball earlier in the game where Ratliff-Williams came down with it. Elliott trying to team up again down near the goal line.
Anthony Ratliff-Williams, 4 catches for 84 yards in this game.
Walston's been a weapon down here, close. They'll run it.
Williams, submarines forward to the 20.
Well, that time Pitt was coming with pressure. They were bringing all their backers on a blitz. They stunted in the hole. Really no place for Williams to go, but give him some credit for keeping the legs churning. Shoots it upfield to get inside the red zone.
Here's our red zone brought to you by CPI Security, official security partner of the ACC. 2 for 2 for Carolina in the red zone with a couple of touchdowns.
Over blitz.
Elliott, end zone. Incomplete. Catch was made, but out of bounds. Incomplete.
Looked like Antoine Green is the guy that goes up and tries to make the play here. Just couldn't quite get that foot down as he's twisting to make the catch.
Just one catch on the season, Dave, coming in for Antoine Green. Did make the grab, but out of bounds. Here's Freeman Jones now. Five of 5 for 5 on the season. He's made it 6 for 6. And now 7 in a row going back to last year for Freeman Jones, who made 4 field goals in the loss at East Carolina a couple of weeks ago. 38-28 and with 1:36 to go, our Yellowwood brand top recruit, Deami Brown, has a touchdown grab here in the third of 19 yards. Our Yellowwood top recruit, Dave.
Yeah, he was the top receivers of the state coming in. He's a guy that can really run. Senior year, had 10 touchdowns receptions. He had 14 receiving touchdowns as a junior at West Mecklenburg High School in Charlotte. Here's his touchdown earlier in the game, his first as a Tar Heel. Does a great job of acting, runs the little delay, and then right down through the middle. And Elliott on the same page with him. And the freshman has his first score when he hopes his many more to come as a Tar Heel.
Freshman from Charlotte, North Carolina, 19 yards on the hookup with Elliott, who has a couple of TD passes. Also threw one to Michael Carter in the second quarter. And now the lead is 10 for North Carolina with 17 points in the quarter. Pittsburgh yet to score. Through the end zone, and we are going to show.
It sounds like that Virginia defense playing pretty well as well. And Perkins doing his job on the offensive side. And the Cavalier defense getting after Cunningham and that Bobby Petrino offense.
That is some stark contrast. Success in the first half, just 2 yards in the second half. Although Maurice French is on the move, there is a penalty flag behind the play, Dave Archer.
There is a flag on the
If it stands, it would be 23 yards. But again, that flag thrown behind the play in the vicinity of the 20-yard line.
Illegal shift by the offense. Two-man moving and not getting set prior to the snap. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Well, this is the first time Sean Watson has shown this wrinkle where they did their kind of the retrace of the jet sweep. Guy French came across the formation, then returned, and they handed him the ball. First time they'd seen that. North Carolina, they did not handle it very well. So he's going to come back now. He's going to come back the same direction. I'm not sure I saw the two people moving there, but it's a big play that comes back for Pitt.
5 penalties against the Panthers. North Carolina has not been flagged this afternoon. First and 15. This is Hall, right side. Bounced out of bounds, and we're going out of the sidelines in Arisha.
Well, before the defense went out there, we heard defensive coordinator John Papuchas tell his players to keep playing. He said, that's it. What you're doing is what you're doing. You must finish, and you must keep playing. He said, keep pounding. And he emphasized that stopping the run was very, very important for them this go-round.
Well, you're right, Larisha. And what John did is he was able to relay to his team exactly what they were doing wrong, because you heard Larry Fedora talking to you and to all of us about how they were not fitting properly against the run. That means these guys got a gap. They've taken care of that so far in the second half.
Pickett's pass right back to him as it got batted down. Trey Morrison knocked it down right back to Pickett.
Tom, this is a kid that John Papuchas, the defensive coordinator, raved about. The freshman from Atlanta, Greater Atlanta Christian. He's going to come off the edge on a blitz from the slot. He elevates in the air because Kenny Pickett trying to throw it behind him, and he bats the ball down. Pickett catches it, ill-advised, catches the ball to lose yardage, but excellent play by the freshman.
There was a 12-yard loss on the play, and we are headed to the fourth quarter. 1-point lead for North Carolina. Pittsburgh has the football. Pickett stepping up. Pickett to the 20. Tries to cut it back near the 25, but can't get there.
You know, Tom, that's an excellent job by North Carolina to plaster coverage. By that, I mean, if you've got a guy downfield, if you're North Carolina, this is long yardage. Pickett's going to break contain right here. North Carolina could have come off coverage to come up and make a play on the quarterback, but everybody in the back end stayed on coverage and allowed their defensive front linebackers to pursue and make the play. Excellent job by North Carolina. Plaster coverage, give Pickett no place to throw the ball.
So now on 4th and 11, Kirk Christodoulou will punt to Daz Newsome. Newsome, fair catch indicated and made successfully at the 43-yard line. A punt at 33 yards from Kirk Christodoulou, and a penalty marker is also out. Well, we sort that out, show you the third quarter stats, and Dave, we're brought to you by Excedrin.
Well, we talked about how much offense there was in the first half. Look at Pitt's number, minus 9 yards on third down. That's just, you can't get any first downs, you can't stay on the field. And of course, North Carolina's continued their average yards per play at 7.2 yards. That's excellent. No penalties. 5 penalties for Pitt right now, 45 yards. That's hidden yards that you can't get back. In fact, it was a huge penalty in that last drive that took away a big run by French.
So they tacked on the penalty yardage against North Carolina, their first infraction of the afternoon. And that sets the ball back at their own 33-yard line.
Well, Pitt can ill afford to allow Carolina to eat clock and put points on the board here. They got to find a way to get a stop.
Up the middle with Carter. Should be a first down.
Kind of a taste of their own medicine. This is something that Pitt does with that jet sweep fake and then hand it straight ahead. Carter found some running room.
Not a lot there for Carter on this particular run on first down.
Now, North Carolina's done a nice job of mixing run and pass. They've got to stay aggressive. And Narducci's team needs to find a way to get a stop here, get the football back to their offense.
Larry Fedora's team, quick turnaround. They've got to play Thursday at number 21, Miami. This pass is incomplete at the boundary. Looking for Brown.
Nathan Elliott's done a nice job for the most part taking care of the ball. He's put it in harm's way a couple of times. Made an ill-advised throw right before the end of the half that didn't result in an interception. But the completion percentage is solid. He's done a good job of reading coverage. He's made some big throws down the field. And a couple of good throws in the end zone as well.
He is our Dickey's hardest working player this afternoon. In perfect conditions with college football. Tom Wormy, Dave Archer, Larisha Harris, and our outstanding ACC college football production crew with you from Chapel Hill, North Carolina on Raycom Sports. Looks like a timeout has been taken by the Pittsburgh Panthers.
Tailgating is a song heard across campuses, parking lots, and open fields. They say this song can be heard elsewhere, and perhaps this is true, but it is nowhere near as bright, nowhere near as loud, nowhere near.
Howard with just 2 seconds to go, 37-36, the dramatic victory for North Carolina. Elliott to Ratliff Williams, the usually capable hands of number 17 in Carolina blue, but that one eludes his grasp.
Boy, excellent throw from Nathan Elliott. They're coming with the blitz. He stands in there and just shoots it right on the money. And as you said, Ratliff Williams, boy, that's the guy he wants to throw to. He's a little stunned himself. You see it on his face. He'll see that from the junior.
Arujo Lopes is the deep man. Hunter Lent to punt for North Carolina. Last two meetings between the teams decided by a total, Dave, of 4 points. Last year, a 3-point win in Pittsburgh for North Carolina. At the 9, Arujo.
Now, Kendall Hinton had a monster game against Clemson a year ago, I believe, before he got injured. So he's been out. First time he's been available for Dave Clawson.
You can see just how close this series has been. Last 7 meetings, average of 4 points. The differential, French on the grab and spun out of bounds shy of the 20 by Miles Wolfolk. Last win in the series, Dave, for the Panthers. You got to go back to the Meineke Car Care Bowl in Charlotte, North Carolina. In 2009, a last-minute field goal won the game 19-17 for the Panthers. Olison gets the call.
Well, you mentioned it earlier, Tom. It's the one team in ACC play Pitt's never beaten. comes to ACC play. It's been tough on them. They're 0-5. Showed a little bit of a sense of urgency after that first down play. Went no huddle. Now they're going to go ahead and huddle here on a really impactful play for them. With winding down towards 12 minutes here, fourth quarter. Big play here for Pitt. Try to extend the drive.
Just 1-4 on third down of the second half of the Panthers. Third and four from the 21-yard line. Pickett out of a crumbling pocket. Broke a tackle. Up the middle of the field and a first down, Kenny Pickett. Toughness and durability and a first down for Pickett.
It looked like Tamon Fox had a chance to end the drive. Number 12 rushing the passer, gets up the field, now going to fold back the inside, but just could not make the tackle. Excellent job of Pickett showing some want to as he ran through the tackle, the defensive end, for a first down. Boy, nice individual effort right there by the young quarterback to keep this drive alive for the Panthers.
Kenny Pickett picked up 15 yards on the play. He's a sophomore from Oakhurst, New Jersey. Had a touchdown run of 7 yards in the first quarter. This time he hands it off to Olsson, trying to drag some Carolina defenders with him. 7 yards, Olsson. Cater on the tackle. There's a player down for North Carolina.
Yeah, might have get held right here. He's getting right here. That's Buxer. Looks like he held on to Strobridge right there and then fell on top of him. He's able to get off the field, as you said, on his own power.
Pickett. He'll go down. Jalen Dalton. Third sack of the game for North Carolina. Dalton just came in the game for Jason Strobridge.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And a good job of stepping in and making a play. Jalen Dalton, the senior from Clemens, North Carolina. This good pass rush, and Pickett stepped out of a lot of these plays today, but not this time. The big fellow, the 6'5", 300-pound senior, wraps him up and puts the quarterback down.
First sack of the season for Dalton.
Yeah, Pat Narduzzi's team now. This is a huge moment for them. Winding down towards 10 minutes, down two scores. They got to find a way to extend the drive. North Carolina showing double A gap, back out of it.
On third and 11, deflected and incomplete. Mack was the intended receiver, flashing across the middle. It's incomplete, and it's fourth down for the Panthers. There is a marker on the field.
It's a motion penalty, another one against Pitt. That's two that they've had here in the second half.
And Dave,
the previous play is under review. It was an illegal shift by the offense. That penalty's declined. The fourth down, the previous play will be reviewed.
They're looking at targeting here, Tom. This is let's take a look here. The throw down the pipe, deflected, and then an elbow strikes Mack in the forehead. So it wasn't a shot to the head by a helmet. And I think this is kind of an incidental contact scenario right here.
Well, Dave, targeting can also involve forcible contact from the shoulder up.
Yeah, no intent here, though. He was jumping in the air. He's not trying to drop the hammer here. He's reacting to the ball being in the air and just kind of braces himself for the two to run together. I don't think there's any reason for a foul here. Ball was tipped as well. See, he's just kind of trying to brace himself to come down. So the elbow looks like caught Mack in the face mask.
Saw two Carolina players, Holcomb and Ross, both go up for that ball and get a piece of it. And then the receiver was Taysir Mack. Boy, the struggles in the second half continue, Dave. North Carolina defensive coordinator John Papuchis. He knows Coach Narduzzi from his days at Michigan State. Papuchis was at Nebraska as an assistant. Riley Johnson is our referee. Left side of your screen, Coach Narduzzi, up and down those sidelines.
Well, Tom, I just don't think this is the definition of the targeting. I'm all in favor of taking care of the receivers in defensive situation. I just don't think that this was a play it warrants that, but it's certainly worth looking at. Does he make some intent with his elbow to try to elbow Mac in the head? I just don't see it.
After reviewing the play, there was no foul for targeting by the defense. There was an illegal shift by the offense. Two men moving, not getting sent prior to the snap. And penalties declined. Fourth down.
I think that's a nice job by the replay to get that right. Certainly worth looking at because they did see Mac go down in an awkward way, but it was just kind of two players bracing each other as they collided.
Newsom lets it bounce, fields it near the 20 and gets popped and driven backwards inside the 15. 47 yards on the punt, negative 4 on the return.
Yeah, both teams had a lot of momentum going at halftime. Which one would hang on to it? Well, it's been North Carolina. Excellent run there by Brown to get in the end zone. And then, of course, their defense has really been what's been the story here in the second half. You did get the throw down the pipe for the touchdown, but you got the turnover on special teams. So all three phases really have played at a high level for North Carolina. Freeman Jones kicks the field goal after that takeaway. He was the guy that recovered the loose ball in the kickoff and then pounded one through to make it a two-score game.
37-yard field goal by Freeman Jones to round out the scoring, 38-28, as we get set to cross the 10-minute threshold of the fourth quarter. So glad that you've been with us this afternoon on Raycom Sports. Extremely entertaining game, as we expected, from North Carolina and Pittsburgh. Antonio Williams. Damar Hamlin with the tackle. North Carolina had its worst starting field position of the game. Not anymore, Dave.
Well, a little window dressing again. And again, this is something similar to what Pitt does, where they bring that guy across in motion. That time Thomas Jackson flashed in front of the quarterback and froze the linebackers just enough to allow that offensive line to get up on that second level and provide a running lane.
18 yards and some breathing room for the Tar Heels from their own 33. First and 10, 9.5 minutes to go in regulation. North Carolina, Dave, the only team in the ACC without a win, albeit small sample size, two losses on the season for Carolina.
Yeah, they've been sitting and waiting as well. Just play, fake the toss, and Elliott gets straight ahead. They've been laying in wait and asked Larry Fedora, was it good to, after losing your first two, to maybe spend a little extra time, get ready? He'd like it. He said, we needed to get right back on the field. They said it's been 300 days since they played in their own building. They were excited to get out here in front of their fans.
Elliott slings it out to the left side. Vargas crosses the 40. Dave, you just mentioned it. 307 days in between home games. Last home game, November 18th of last year against Western Carolina, and a win 65-10. And there is a penalty marker on the field. All of a sudden, we've been bogged down here in the second half with penalty markers. Not a lot on North Carolina.
Here to hold it. During the play, holding by number 17 on the offense. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
Kind of a late call, too. Ratliff Williams is blocking out in front of Vargas after that catch.
Third penalty, Dave, against the Tar Heels.
He's the guy flagged.
Here's our first and 10 line, brought to you by LendingTree, official loan shopping partner of the ACC. Got to get out past the 43-yard line on third and 12. Direction second down. Around the corners, Michael Carter, first down, North Carolina.
Yeah, this is a heck of a call, Tom, because they come with the call from the sideline. Kapilovic, Chris Kapilovic, their offensive coordinator, has done a good job of mixing run and pass, and they saw that they had Pitt outflanked to the left, ran the little lead option, or not even a lead option, just straight option with Elliott and Carter. And a good decision by Elliott to kick it out to his fast running back for a first down.
15 yards on that last play. Tar Heels up to 151 yards rushing. This will be a pass. Newsom, shifty, inside the 40. Daz Newsom racing down the sideline and clipped down near the 5. Cam Bright, touchdown saving tackle, 47 yards.
Just a quick screen to the outside. Bargus gets the key block, and then we've been talking all day long. This is the guy that Larry Fedora wants in space, is Daz Newsome, his ability to make people miss. He shows it right there.
Tar Heels working quickly to Carter. Stifled and stopped. Amir Watts making the tackle.
Yeah, Amir Watts, 34, gets immediate penetration on this play, something they needed, right through the A-gap, and slows Carter down and allows a host of Panthers to get there and make the play. Watts has made a couple plays in the backfield today for Pitt. Boy, this is a big moment for them to try to stand up, keep North Carolina out of the end zone.
Loss of three on the previous play, second and goal. For North Carolina, which has dominated the second half and threatening again. Carter. There is a flag. Michael Carter, who did not play in the first two games of the season.
Illegal formation by the offense. 5 men in the backfield. 5 yard penalty. Second down.
So one of those mistakes that drives you crazy as a coach when you get young kids that are playing. Some of these guys are freshmen. Barry Fedora playing a lot of young players, and somebody didn't get up on the ball like they're supposed to in the formation, and so that play comes back. See how much Carolina likes to spread the offense out where Pitt has to respond to all these players out here. Try to minimize how many are in the box to run the football against the six-man box.
Newsom's gone over 100 yards receiving. 6 catches for 110 yards. Here's the run. Quick move by Williams off to the left. And down to the 11-yard line.
Yeah, Carolina will be very comfortable in running the football. And just as Camp, again, bursts through the middle and kind of forced Williams wide. Good job of changing his track and getting a decent game, but North Carolina going to be very comfortable letting this clock bleed down, which is kind of contrary to who they are. They like to play fast. Up 2 scores here.
From the 11, third and goal. Elliott, and that pocket disintegrates in front of him. Patrick Jones, the second, leads the way for the Panthers.
Just the first, that's the first sack this offensive line for North Carolina has given up on the year. And it's a good decision by Nathan Elliott. Didn't really see what was going on downfield, Tom. It was not a clean throw, so he decides to eat the football. He's going to get a chance to get his kicker on the field for a field goal attempt here, but a good decision there by Elliott, the quarterback. He's made a lot of good decisions today. I only think of one where he maybe pushed the ball into coverage.
38-yard attempt. Freeman Jones, who was also made from 37 yards, and this one is no good. Outside the right pipe. One of two on the day, and a miss from 38 yards away. So
picked up the slack for North Carolina running the football.
Pickett wants to throw. Near sideline. Twisting receiver. Arujo Lopes, well defended.
Boy, being covered again by the freshman, Trey Morrison. He's had a day now. Number 27, the nickelback.
Check in with Marisha. Injury update.
We saw Jason Strobridge go down earlier in the game. Well, now he's back in, and he seems to be good to go.
Well, Strobridge is one of those heart and soul guys, Larisha, up front. And they love having him on the field. Missing Crawford, Aaron Crawford up front. They needed to have one of their heart and soul guys, and Strobridge is one of those guys.
Pickett again to throw. Same part of the field. Diving attempt at the 45-yard line. Taysier Mack.
Well, this is a beautiful throw by Pickett because he's going to eat a helmet to let it go now. He's going to put up Mack on the deep shot, but watch Pickett stand in, take the shot, and this ball is right on the money. Excellent job of making a contested catch, and they're going to take a look at this to see if Mack actually did squeeze this one on the back end, but our initial look is that Mack reeled it in at about the North Carolina 45-yard line.
If it stands, Dave, it will be a 34-yard pickup for Pittsburgh. The ruling on the field is catch. You
what
must have indisputable video evidence to overturn the call.
Good. I like to hear that. All right, here, let's take a look if we have the indisputed
indisputable video evidence that the ball came out. Remember, they called it a catch on the field. So it has to be indisputable that he dropped it. And I don't see that. It looks like a catch to me. That's a completion. It's an excellent play by Mack. Watch him get the elbows together, secure the ball, does not slip through his arms.
This is a critical moment in the game. Prior to that connection, if it does stand, Dave, Pickett was just one of three for 4 yards.
That's a catch right there.
After review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. First down.
That's a big-time catch by Mack when they need it most. And you talk about the quarterback. You got to stand in and take some shots to make some plays down the field. And Pickett's been willing to do that all day long, and that's Tamon Fox coming in. He's been around the quarterback most of the day. Got a sack on the day. Good job by Pickett to stand in there and let it go.
103 sacks of the afternoon for North Carolina, but that play will stand. 34 yards on the connection. Pickett back to the air. He's got a man near the 35-yard line. Shockey Jacques-Louis for 9 yards.
Another freshman. Something that Pitt's done a good job of is going down into Florida. And Jacques-Louis, Fort Myers, Florida, Dunbar High School. He's an early enrollee for them. They're excited about his future.
Panthers gaining some traction on offense. Couple of completions in a row. Now looking for the home run of the end zone. It's too far. For the intended receiver, Mack, K.J. Sayles, providing coverage for North Carolina.
That's a good read. K.J. Sayles gets beat on the fade route. And it's Mack again, inside fade. Sayles can't stay with him. And just a little bit more trajectory, a little bit more air on the ball, and Pickett would have had a touchdown right there.
Keep in mind, Dave, the Panthers have not scored points of any kind in the fourth quarter all season long. This their fourth game of the year after beating Georgia Tech last Saturday, 24-19. Lost to Penn State, but a win against Albany to open up the season for the Panthers. 2 of 6 in the second half on third down. Olsen, first down, Pittsburgh.
We're back to the bread and butter, the big fella Olsen. Finds a little room off that left side and skates for a first down.
9 yards on the run by Olsen. The AP Top 25 brought to you by Progressive Insurance, but Boston College, Dave, with a loss today for the Eagles. 30-13 for Boston College as they lost on the road at Purdue.
First time they've been ranked since 08. Did not handle that very well, and Purdue gets the win.
Pickett has to step up. Pickett's got some room. And Pickett's charge slides down inside the 15.
Wow, he went Civil War on him. It's called. I guess it's fitting. It was in Pennsylvania, right?
11 yards on the run. Didn't work out so well for Pickett, though, in Gettysburg. Here in Chapel Hill, that pass play does not work out all that well for Pickett either. Looking for Butler Jenkins.
Yeah, I think Pickett expected Butler Jenkins to retrace his steps, come down inside of it, and go back to the outside, and that's not what he did. He was coming in all the way. I think that, you know, Pitt's moved the football well here, but they're down here deep now. Can't waste a lot of time if somebody's tackled in bounds. Got to be a little bit more sense of urgency. Down 2 scores here.
Panthers 3 for 3 in the red zone with 3 touchdowns this afternoon. 2nd and 10 to that front corner. Adjusting to the football. And Maurice French, it is incomplete. The official right on top of the play.
And he's called it incomplete. French is arguing with the play. Pat Narduzzi can't believe it either. Called it incomplete. Let's take a look at the back end of the play. French on an underthrown pass.
Review.
This would be a better look right here. He certainly juggled it initially.
Looks like he still has it, Dave, as he rolls around. It was Sayles trying to.
Yeah, Sayles is going to get the right hand in and jars the ball a little bit, but I didn't necessarily see it come out. Looks like he's got it pinned to his side. Let's take a look here. Watch Sayles get the right hand in. He's going to jar the ball loose just a little bit. but it didn't look like the ball came out.
I will say this, Dave. We have the benefit of replay. It's being reviewed right now. And the official, right of the screen, right on top of the play,
right
less
here.
Than 10 yards away, he's got the call.
He sees the ball get jarred a little bit by Sale's right hand.
Now, Dave, the call on the field is incomplete pass. So you must have indisputable video evidence to overturn this call, and it appears it just might be there.
Yeah, it's not. Well, I don't know. I don't know if it's conclusive of whether the ball touched the ground or not. And so because you said it was called, as you said, it's called incomplete, is there something conclusive there that tells him that he did squeeze it? Because the ball's jarred loose. It comes loose a little bit on the side. You're going to call a touchdown.
Okay. The evidence appears to be there potentially. The replay official is Andrew Panucci. He is on the headset with Riley Johnson, and both coaches awaiting the result of the deliberation.
As he hits the ground, it certainly looks like he's got it cradled.
Dave, the right forearm, I believe, to be underneath the football as he rolls around. Sales did get a piece of it right there trying to punch it out. Watch the right forearm, and he braces it right up against his hip.
Got it pinned against his side. I would give him a touchdown.
Once again, the official is right in front of the play.
Now, what you can't see is as French rolls to his right, does the ball come loose right there and then reestablish it against the side?
After reviewing the play, the receiver had possession of the football in the end zone, touchdown.
That's good. That's what replay's for, is to get it right. French did a good job of kind of battling Sales on an underthrown ball here. Was able to squeeze it for the touchdown.
You can certainly understand why the official would signal incomplete.
Well, certainly Sales, it looked like he got it loose a little
bit.
He
did.
But he never got it out of there.
That right forearm stayed under the ball, Dave, and he pinned it against that hip as well.
Yeah, I think referee Tom Wormy got that one right.
Well, the adjustment of the ball by French as well was outstanding. And Pittsburgh, nothing was going right in the second half for the Panthers, but what a drive. 38-35, Maurice French, I want the TD, and it is granted, and we'll be back after a word from your local ACC. Thanks to the 16-yard touchdown reception, first of the season for Maurice French. It is our Bass Pro Shops catch of the game.
Well, good job for getting this right, because this is a huge play in the game, and now one score game with Pitt having the ability, if they want to kick it off.
Flag came out of the kickoff.
Oh, kicked it out of bounds. Huge mistake.
There might be two mistakes here. Offside initially, and then it goes out of bounds.
They can live with the offside penalty. North Carolina had nobody back. They were anticipating onside kick.
There are two fouls, both by the kicking team. Kick out of bounds by the kicking team. Also, there was an offside. That penalty will be declined. Spotted at the 35-yard line. First down.
To help people affected by Hurricane Florence, text Florence to 90999 to give $10 to the American Red Cross. Terms and conditions apply.
All right, goal here now for North Carolina will be obviously to get first downs. And Pitt will sell out against the run. So how aggressive will North Carolina be in throwing the football? I would assume they'll run it and try to make Pitt eat their timeouts. They have two left.
Antonio Williams.
And a good decision by Pat Narduzzi not to use one here. He has two. So he'll hit the clock run. Let's see if Nathan Elliott now has played enough football where his job is to eat clock. And the coaching staff, a lot of these calls come from the sideline now. The coaches can help them eat clock by waiting to get the call in.
Last year, the teams played in early November. That was a Thursday night, Dave, in Pittsburgh, in a 34-31 win for North Carolina. The previous year, 2016, last meeting here, 37-36 in a win for North Carolina. They've never lost to Pittsburgh as ACC foes. Elliott leaping for the 40-yard line, just shy of it, and 3 yards.
And Pat Narduzzi burns his second timeout of the halves.
So 2:21 to go. Don't forget next Saturday. Tune in at noon for the ACC Blitz, powered by the all-new 2019 Ram 1500. Katie and Tommy in the studio. NC State, as Dave mentioned, later on today against Marshall, and that's at 7 o'clock. All right, Ratliff Williams ready to accept the direct snap. Third and five. Ratliff Williams cuts it at the 40. Up to midfield and a first down for North Carolina.
Boy, Weaver had done a great job all game long of containing the edge. And he does a poor job this time. Ratliff Williams is going to fake the handoff. Look at the edge player crash. That's Weaver 17. He allows Ratliff Williams to flank him, and with the great speed gets the first down. And that's really all North Carolina was looking for, was trying to extend the drive and now to eat clock. Pitt with only one timeout left. Now going to be a tall order for them to try to get the ball back.
12 yards on the run by Ratliff Williams, as you saw, had to go to that North Carolina sideline for further evaluation at the end of that play. Tar Heels a minute 38 from their first win of the season. There is some movement along that line. There was a timeout called by North Carolina.
Timeout, North Carolina. First charge of this half.
What an afternoon for the Tar Heels, who right now hold on to a three-point lead, 38-35. Das Newsome, a critical part of the effort this afternoon for the Heels.
Well, it was fun talking to Larry Fedora. When you ask, okay, who are guys that can light it up for you? Well, he said, we need to get the ball to Das Newsome today. This guy is lightning in a bottle. If we can get it to him, he's going to make people miss. And he did that today. Went over 100 yards, his first 100-yard game of his career. And Das Newsome, what an outstanding day.
He's our local Chevy dealer's performance of the game. Six catches, career high 110 yards for Das Newsome, sophomore from Hampton, Virginia. Nathan Elliott has also had a strong game for North Carolina. 313 yards passing on 22 completions, a career high for Nathan Elliott. And has a couple of TD passes in the second and third quarters of 31 and 19 yards. And North Carolina trying to work that clock on the Pittsburgh side of the 50.
Give offensive coordinator Chris Kapilovic a lot of credit to use his weapons. He got a good performance from his offensive line today. They had struggled against East Carolina 2 weeks ago. They played much better today against Pittsburgh.
Panthers have taken their last timeout of the game with 1:29 to go. We talked about the keys to victory this afternoon. North Carolina trying to extend its winning streak against the Panthers to 6. And they may be able to do it, Dave, as we revisit those keys.
Yeah, it was finished the game for Pitt, and they just didn't get it done again. Only 7 points, 105 yards in the second half, 3 for 7 on third down. And how good can you be on first down to give yourself an opportunity for North Carolina to be in good, manageable second and third down situation? They got it done. 7.1 yards on first down. I mean, you couldn't ask for anything more as an offense. And I think Coach Fedora will be excited about the way his offense. There's Chris Kapilovic, the offensive coordinator, does an outstanding job here at North Carolina.
5th year as the offensive coordinator. Was an assistant at Southern Miss to Larry Fedora. And now we'll keep an eye on that clock. North Carolina can work it way down. This is Williams. Oh, he's got a first down on the outside, and Williams did not stay in bounds. The 32-yard line as Hamlin forced him out. But it's been North Carolina in the second half, Dave, outscoring Pittsburgh 17-7.
You can go ahead and call it ball game now, because North Carolina now going to get a chance to kneel down on the ball. And Coach Fedora talked about rebooting the system. We've really struggled here in this state with the storm and trying to help all our people of North Carolina. And you can continue to do that as some of the numbers we put up for you to continue to contribute to those that are struggling in the Eastern Carolinas. But this North Carolina team rebooted the system, and they played extremely well today, and they get a win in conference, and even more importantly, get a win in their own division against the team that had come in and won in the division last week against Georgia Tech.
And now North Carolina will improve to 6-0 at home against the Pittsburgh Panthers, and 6-0 overall against the Panthers as members of the Atlantic Coast Conference. 6 wins in a row. And that expression from Coach Narduzzi will tell you what went down this afternoon. We expected a close game. It's exactly what we got. It appears that 3 points will be the difference. So once again, the last 7 meetings decided by an average of 4 points. And now a flag has come out with 43 seconds on the clock.
Illegal substitution here.
Illegal substitution by the offense. 12 players in formation. 5-yard penalty. Second out.
And those little administrative things don't please any coaches, as you can see Larry Fedora not overly excited about that. He is excited about getting the win today. Been a lot of noise here in North Carolina over the last couple of weeks. Not just storm noise, but certainly what's going on with the program. And Larry Fedora, outstanding football coach, has a great staff. They put together a nice game plan today, and their kids played 4 quarters of football.
He's going to move to 6-1 in home openers. And that should do it, Dave. North Carolina, Larry Fedora will allow himself a small smile.
Well, his quarterback played well, Elliott, today. He talked about, hey, he's got to play. He doesn't need to overthink things, just turn it loose. And he got that from his quarterback today.
6 wins in a row for the Tar Heels against the Panthers as Pittsburgh comes up short once again, 38-35. What a performance by both teams, but in the end, North Carolina has its first win of the season. For highlights and must-see moments from this game and others, check out the ACC.com. Join us for the ACC Blitz, powered by the all-new 2019 Ram 1500, next Saturday, noon Eastern, followed by Virginia at NC State. You've been watching coverage of Atlantic Coast Conference football, an exclusive production of Raycom.